would love to greet everybody with the wonderful name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen?
Amen.
So in opening, let us close our eyes in prayer. We thank you for this wonderful day, Lord. We thank you for everything. We thank you for the gift of life, Lord. Lord, we ask you to please give us wisdom from above, Lord, as we're going to be doing your program, Lord. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Amen.
Happy Sabbath again. On my left hand side, we have Sister Etta, my sister. And she's going, our topic for today is going to be about a new start. Before I forget, my name is Oyintanda Qamata, and we're going to be speaking about new start. So she's going to be telling us what is the meaning of new, and I'm going to be telling you what is the meaning of start. Over to you, Sister Etta.
Okay. I'd like to pray to all in the wonderful name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Okay. As Sister Oyi said, that I'm going to be talking about new. So this, as you can see, I've highlighted all the start, like, you see all the letters that I've highlighted stand for new. So N stands for nutrition. Nutrients are foods, like when you eat foods, like you benefit things. You can benefit nutrition and vitamins and all those other stuff, etc. Exercise. Exercise is, there's many types of exercise. We'll show you some at the end of the video, so stay tuned. Exercise, we exercise so we can keep the temple of God proper and etc. Water. We have to drink 8 glasses of water every single day. Here's water, for those who don't know water. I'm sure everyone knows water though. Then there's a verse that I'm going to be reading for keeping our the temple of God, which comes from 1 Corinthians 6 verse 19 to 20. It says, do you know that your bodies are the temples of the Holy Spirit, who is in you, whom you have received from God? You are not your own. You were bought at a price. Therefore, honor God with your bodies. So, basically what this verse says is that take care of your bodies. Do not do bad things. Do not smoke. Do not drink alcohol and all those bad things. So, I want us to please try our best to do 8 glasses of water every single day and exercise. If you can't every single day, but please try your best to exercise. And do not eat unhealthy foods only. Balance, have a balanced diet. Thank you.
I would love to greet everyone once more in the wonderful name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
So I'm going to be speaking about start. So as you can see, sunlight. I don't know if it's clear. Sunlight. So sunlight, we all need sunlight in our daily life, you know? Even though sometimes we don't have sunlight some days, well, we actually do need sunlight. So we need sunlight at least 20 to 30 minutes a day, because we need to, our bodies need vitamin D, right? For energy, we need energy in our bodies. And to keep our houses clean, because you know sunlight most kills germs. So we need sunlight to get into our houses to kill germs. Temperance. Temperance means to eat at moderation. Always think about your temperance. Or if I eat this much, how about my temperance? If I eat too much cholesterol, what about my? If I eat too much oil, what about? You know, eat at moderation. And always we need air for we need fresh air, not just air. We need fresh air. Like for example, if we breathe in smoke, is it good for our bodies? No, it's going to affect our lungs and make us sick. So that's why it is very important for us to breathe in fresh and good air. Rest. We all need rest in our life. We know that if we don't rest, we get exhausted. You know, if we don't rest, we get exhausted. And this also applies to adults and kids. In our life, in our daily life, we need to rest 8 to 10 hours, 8 to 10 hours, so that we get energy. You know, yeah. Trust in the Lord. We always need to trust in the Lord. I believe that if we do not think these things are going to be possible, then trust in the Lord, because everything is possible to in the Lord. There's a verse in Philippians 4 verse 30. It says, I can do all things through Christ who gives me strength. So if you think you are failing this, always know, I can do all things through Christ who gives me strength. Philippians 4 verse 30. So, since we are done, we are going to be showing you some exercises. So, please stay tuned for our exercises we're going to be doing. So, let's go! So, this exercise is the first exercise, which is like a 2-in-1. So, this exercise is like running and cycling. It exercises your whole entire body. Thank you. Okay, so this is called cycling. So, cycling, it burns fat on your legs. And it also burns fat. Cycling is one of the exercises that make you lose weight, make you fit, balance circulation, and make you more stronger. So this is cycling. This is running. We just did some running, an exercise that helps you with your heart and makes your heart stronger and helps. It works the whole body. It makes you also burn fat, builds your muscles, and makes you more fit. So that is running.
Now as we have reached the end of our program, I would like us to close in a word of prayer. Thank you, Father God, for a wonderful day. Jesus, thank you for everything that you have done, Father God. Jesus, we love you, Father God. And please help us to all get a new start, Father God. Jesus. Amen. Thank you.